What are we going to talk about today?
I thought we had this all figured out before you pressed the record button.
We did, but I'm having some short-term memory problems.
Does this help?
No, not really.
We were going to talk about COVID-19,
The Kung Flu!
That is not the right way to say it. Instead of calling you Pushy, can I just change the H to S and call you that?
Howdy folks, welcome to our channel. I am Pushy.
I'm Mushy.
And we're the Pushy Mushy. Yay! Serious. So, be serious is actually a gram-positive bacillus that has the potential to cause food poisoning.
Seriously.
So, seriously, we are here to provide our views of our current society from an Asian perspective. Now, we do not represent all Asians, and we certainly are not the gold standard for Asian opinion. What we are trying to do is to provide you with a taste of how certain Asians feel about our current society and how we have come to adapt to it. We will do our best to combine facts with humor, but if we do make mistakes, please let us know and we will do our best to correct. What we're also hoping to do is provide you with some laughter at times, some guidance at times, some inspirations at times, and hopefully make your days go by a little easier. Please like or dislike, hopefully not dislike, subscribe, comment, share, and press that bell icon.
Great. So tell us about COVID-19.
It's a virus.
That answer seems kind of short.
Well, I try to touch fish whenever I can, my dear.
Don't touch fish.
All right, I'm sorry. So COVID-19 stands for Coronavirus 2019.
What happened in 2019?
The Toronto Raptors won the NBA championship, and Mr. Boris Johnson became the Prime Minister of the United Kingdom.
I'm asking about COVID-19.
So at the end of 2019, A novel coronavirus was identified as the cause of a cluster of pneumonia cases in Wuhan, a city in Hubei province of China. And because of this origin, COVID-19 also received some cute nicknames such as the Kung Flu or Chinese virus.
Too controversial. China's in the middle.
Well, what I was trying to provide was a personal side of COVID-19. How it affected me. So because of these cute nicknames, a very small proportion of our patient population sort of mistreated some of our Asian healthcare workers in the front line. For example, I was once urged by a patient to stop bringing the China virus here. But I am from China. My grandparents were born in China, but I have never been to China. Scenarios like this really affected so many Asian healthcare workers, which was very discouraging. But at the end of the day, most of us remained professional and wished nothing but the best for the patients we cared for. Have you encountered any situation like this in your profession?
Unfortunately, yes. But that's not the topic today. So, what is COVID-19 right now?
It's bad. People are getting sick and dying everywhere. And sadly, and I'm not trying to get political here, some people still do not believe that COVID is real.
What do you mean?
Well, I had a patient whom I was caring for. And one morning as I was rounding on him and telling him the plans and the management of the day, he thanked me, but he also asked me, "Doc, what do I really have?" And I told him, COVID-19 pneumonia. Then he said, no, what do I really, really have? You know, situations like this, they're really disheartening, but unfortunately that's the reality.
Wow. So what should people do if they think they have COVID-19?
Well, they should certainly get in touch with their physicians, or if they do not feel well or cannot wait for a response from their primary care doctors, they should consider going to the urgent care clinic, the emergency room, or calling 911 for EMS.
Okay, so what should people do when they know they actually have COVID-19?
Well, if they are not admitted to the hospital, they should quarantine themselves per guidelines from the CDC and the instructions they receive from their doctors. Most COVID-19 patients with mild symptoms who are not admitted to the hospital should quarantine for 10 days counting from symptom onset. Most patients with moderate to severe COVID-19 infection should quarantine themselves for 20 days starting from symptom onset.
So what should people do to minimize or prevent the spread of COVID-19?
Well, I'm fairly sure most people are aware of these measures at this point. But without getting into conspiracy theories and one's constitutional rights, social distancing and mask wearing are the first steps. Mm-hmm. Then there are now the vaccines. I'm not here to preach or lecture, and I'm not here to change anyone's view of life. But I've seen COVID-19 infections destroying lives and families, regardless of gender, race, political parties, sexual orientations, or cultural background. Mm-hmm. I've also seen how hard frontline healthcare workers work to fight for and protect our patients. Over the past year, I think most frontline healthcare workers have felt overworked or burnt out, or what we call the COVID fatigue. Yet, over the past month or so, there have been so much optimism and so many smiles on so many of these same people's faces because of vaccine development and administration. I think everyone should be vaccinated against COVID-19.
Are vaccines safe?
Yes, there might be some minor side effects, but these vaccines against COVID-19 are generally very safe if you believe in science.
Are vaccines effective?
If you believe in science, yes.
Okay. Have you been vaccinated though?
Yes, 2 full doses.
Do most healthcare workers get it though?
Great question. And if you count greater than 50% as most, then yes, most healthcare workers are vaccinated, but definitely not everyone in healthcare gets vaccinated.
Why is that the case? Meaning, why isn't everyone getting vaccinated?
All right. So here is my chance to be offensive and rude.
No, be professional and be informing.
All right, so I'm sorry. The truth is, I don't know. And I think only those people who are not getting vaccinated can tell you why they're not getting vaccinated. However, I do think one of the reasons is because people are probably having less faith in science than before.
Would you like to send folks who do not believe in science or vaccine a sincere message though?
Oh, that's a sharp question. I think there are all kinds of people in our society. In my opinion, what separates human beings from animals is our ability to for higher thinking, such as questioning, reasoning, problem solving, and critical thinking. I cannot, and I certainly do not have the right to change what people believe in, but if you believe in science somewhat, I encourage you to read through the scientific trials from our vaccine companies. If you ever switch from no vaccine to a yes vaccine, I personally think it is very courageous and noble for those of us who adapt our beliefs and actions for the right reasons and a higher or better purpose. I do not agree with anti-vaxxers. However, I will never discriminate against anti-vaxxers. And if there is ever a chance for me to work with any anti-vaxxer out there that would improve our society such that by the time we leave, this place is better than when we came, I wouldn't hesitate a bit to maximize that opportunity. We're the Pushy Mushy. Thanks for watching.